Next, let's see properties of colloids. Properties of colloids one by one. First one, colligative properties. Already in solutions I have discussed what are colligative properties. Say, what are colligative properties? The properties of dilute solutions which depend only on the number of solute particles but not on the nature of solute are said to be colligative properties. The properties of dilute solution which do not depend on the nature but depend on the number of solute particles are said to be colligative properties. There are four colligative properties. What are they? Relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation in the boiling point, depression in the freezing point, the last one is osmotic pressure. These are the four colligative properties. Now question is, between true solution and colloidal solution, which will have more colligative property? Between true solution and colloidal solution, which will have more colligative property? So for that, answer is true solution. Why true solution than a colloidal solution is having more colligative property? Yes, there are more number of particles in the true solution. In a colloidal solution, you know, there are aggregates of 100 or more than 100 particles. That means, you know, in a true solution, suppose there are 1000 particles, na? In a colloidal solution, what happens in that 1000? Each 100 form a colloidal range particle. That means each colloidal particle, if is considered as association of 100 solute particles in the true solution. Now in that colloidal solution, how many colloidal particles there will be? Yes, 10. Why? 10 × 100, 1000. So in a true solution, 1000 individual particles. Whereas in colloidal solution, 10 aggregates. Each aggregate contains 100 molecules. This each aggregate is in colloidal range. That's why where there are more number of solute particles, in true solution or colloidal solution? Yes, true solution. That's why colligative property, CP means colligative property of a colloidal solution or salt is lesser than colligative property of a solution. Solution is the word used for true solution, where salt is the word used for colloidal solution. Okay, so about colligative properties it is. Second one, there is an important property for both IPE and Object 2, that is Tyndall effect. What is that? Tyndall effect. What is this? It is an optical property of colloidal solution. Tyndall effect is optical property of colloidal solution. What is Tyndall effect? Take in a vessel a true solution first. It's a true solution. Pass a beam of light through it. Passes through the solution without any deviation. When the solution is observed in the direction of propagation of light, the solution appears clear. Place this true solution in a beaker in a dark room. Place a beaker containing true solution in a dark room. Pass a beam of light through it. It is a light beam. When this light beam is passed through true solution and it is observed in the direction of, when it is observed in the direction of light beam, this true solution simply appears clear. When we observe this solution in the direction at a right angles to the light propagation, that means here, when you observe from here, when you observe from here, what happens? It appears dark. So when a true solution is observed in the direction of light propagation, it appears clear. But when it is observed at right angles to the direction of light, it appears dark. If we do the same experiment with a colloidal solution, what happens? Now here, let us take a colloidal solution in a beaker. It is colloidal solution in a beaker. It is a colloidal solution in a beaker. Now, pass a light beam through it. So, this is some light source. This is some light source. Place a lens here. This is lens. From this light source, light rays are coming. Now, this is focused. This is a lens and it is like this. So, if you see the colloidal solution in the dark, in the propagation of light, initially place the colloidal solution in a dark room, pass a beam of light through it. When you observe this colloidal solution through this light beam, what happens? It appears not so clear, but somewhat cloudy. It appears somewhat cloudy. And when you observe it at a right angles to the direction of light, when you observe this light at a right angles to the light, what happens? The path of beam is illuminated. This path of beam is illuminated. It was first observed by Faraday, this type of effect by a colloidal solution is first observed by Faraday. After that, studied in detail by Tyndall. That's why this type of phenomena exhibited by colloidal solution is called Tyndall effect. You know, Tyndall effect is due to scattering of light by colloidal particles, because colloidal particles are somewhat larger than the particles of solute in a true solution. That's why when light falls on it, it simply scatters the light in all directions. Because of this scattering, the light beam is illuminated. So this type of illumination of light beam, when it is observed at right angles to the direction of light by the scattering of light by colloidal particles, is called Tyndall effect. So Tyndall effect is due to which concept? Scattering of light by colloidal particles. We may observe this Tyndall effect in a cinema hall also. You know, in a cinema hall, there will be dust and smoke particles inside the hall. These particles scatter during the projection of a picture. During the projection of picture, these particles, smoke and dust particles, scatter the light. That's why the path of light beam is illuminated. So, this type of illumination of light path by colloidal particles is called Tyndall effect. Here, see, if you see, there are two light beams. These are called what? Tyndall cones. These are called Tyndall cones. These are called Tyndall cones. This is one cone. This is another cone. So, because of Tyndall effect, these are observed. Tyndall effect means what? Scattering of light. by colloidal particles and making the light beam bluish or some illumination is called Tyndall effect. Okay, so simply what is Tyndall effect? Tyndall effect is nothing but it is the illumination of light, illumination of light by illumination of light by the scattering of light by colloidal particles, by the scattering of light by colloidal particles. It was